Hey, what is up, guys? My name is Oleg. This is Bond. Welcome back to the channel. On this channel, we don't shy away from a good homage. I reviewed both Courget and Neymar, which are, of course, Tudor Black Bay Heritage homage watches. Now, on both video reviews, I got questions of people asking which one should they choose? Which one is the better homage? So, in today's video, we're going to compare the two watches side by side, and I'm going to try to answer that question. Which one is the better homage? Let's get into it. All right, so here are the two watches we're going to compare today. On the left, we have the Courget Tudor Black Bay homage. On the right, we have the Neymar 300 meters, also sort of a Black Bay homage. So what are the differences between these two watches? I'll try to keep this video as short as possible. It's not going to be a dual style video where I have 10 categories and rate each watch out of 10. I don't think you need to do that because there's clearly one watch that's better than the other. So both watches have stainless steel cases and they both come on stainless steel bracelets. First difference is the fact that the Neymar has a signed crown versus the Courget does not have a signed crown. The quality of the brushing on the case is clearly better on the Neymar. We even have this helium escape valve. Also the bezel, both watches have quite a thin bezel with this bezel insert. This one is black and of course Courget is blue. The bezel action is much better on the Neymar. It's more solid, it's more clicky. It's 120 clicks as opposed to 90 clicks on the Courget, and just more satisfying, and it actually aligns properly. Versus the Courget, I do like the blue bezel better than the black bezel on the Neymar. However, of course, Neymar comes in many different colors, so that's not a big plus for the Courget. However, just listen to the sound of this bezel. It just sounds tinny. It's too easy to turn. It doesn't align properly, and it's a 90 click bezel. Taking a closer look at the two dials. So this time, let's start with the Courget. We have all applied indices for our markings, and we have this snowflake set of hands. However, if you watch the review of this watch, I should mention that there are reviews for both of these watches available on the channel. The set of hands don't match the indices. This white on the hands is too white as comparing to kind of a creamy white on the indices. So it almost looks like they stuck a piece of paper onto the hands. Maybe it doesn't show that well on the camera, but in person, it's very noticeable. Let's look at this one here. Again, all applied indices. And we do have Mercedes hands as opposed to the snowflake hands. And some of the people mentioned in the unboxing of this watch as well as the review of this watch, again, that review is available on the channel, that this watch is reminiscent of the Tudor Black Bay in terms of the case shape, but it's also reminiscent of the Rolex Sea Dweller. And I can see that. It does have kind of parts taken from both of these watches, which is kind of cool. It's nice to have a watch that's not just following one homage. It's not following one design trend. It's trying to take different pieces from different watches. It even has the 6 and the 9, similar to the Rolex Explorer models. So far, Neymar has been pulling ahead from the Courget. I think where Courget wins some points back is on this bracelet. I really do like this bracelet. You can see that there's no protruding link. That's something that really makes me, not angry, but really that bothers me about a lot of homage watches. And that's that protruding link. As you can see, the Neymar has it. It's not so bad on the Neymar, but it's there and it makes the watch larger. Just look at the difference in terms of the profile, how it wears on the wrist. You can see it adds quite a bit of height to the case. The bracelet also has solid end links, and also what's surprising, it has screw pins as opposed to the push-pull pins like in the Neymar. Also has the engineered clasp, fold over, kind of mimics again the design of the Tudor Black Bay in the design. However, the clasp is not very secure, so if I just go like that, it opens. Neymar also has solid end links and solid links, as I mentioned, just push-pull style pins. It just has a pressed metal clasp. Not as solid as the Courget. Fold over, these two
buttons to release the release mechanism, and this fold over safety with the Neymar written across. Where Neymar pulls ahead again is in the movement. So the movement in the Neymar is the Seiko NH35 movement, 24 joules, 41 hours of power reserve, hacking and hand winding, versus the movement in Courget is the Miura A215 movement, a very respectable, solid movement, accurate, robust, lasts for a long time. However, this movement doesn't have hacking, so it kind of loses out. And I think comparing Miura A215 versus Seiko NH35, I think Seiko NH35 is a better movement. The crown action on the Neymar is much better than Courget. Courget kind of feels cheapo, feels like a lot of corners were cut, or some corners were cut. I shouldn't say a lot of corners, because for the price, it still is a pretty damn good watch. However, Neymar just has a much smoother crown. The threading on the crown is much better. Of course, both watches have screw down crowns. Neymar offers 300 meters of water resistance versus Courget 200 meters of water resistance. Now, I'm not sure how true the 300 meter water resistance rating is, because it's not ISO certified. Both watches do have sapphire crystals, which is really good if you consider the price points that the watches are sold at. So what are my final thoughts? Which one of the watches should you buy? Well, I think honestly, for the price, both watches are really good. I mean, the Neymar is better. I think it has more benefits, better finishes, better bezel action, better crown action, better movement than the Courget. Courget does have a better bracelet and better clasp, arguably better clasp. I don't know. It has the engineered clasp, but it's not as safe as the fold-over pressed metal clasp of Neymar. Either way, I think Neymar wins over the Courget. It is more expensive though.
All right guys, so that was the comparison between the Courget and the Neymar. If you want a better quality watch and a watch that has a bit of an original flair to it, it is an homage of a Tudor Black Bay, but it does have some certain unique elements, then go with the Neymar. If you want a watch that looks pretty much exactly like the Tudor Black Bay heritage and you're willing to sacrifice some quality control issues here and there, then Courget is your choice. I think whichever watch you choose, you won't be disappointed too much, especially for the price, or maybe skip both watches and go with something else. I appreciate you watching this video until the end. Please leave a comment in the comment section below. Let me know which one out of the two you prefer. And maybe there is a third kind of a wild card watch that I didn't consider for this comparison. So if there is one, please suggest it. Maybe I'll look into it in the future. By the way, today on my wrist, I'm wearing my Richard Legrand Odyssey. Really like this diver. Another excellent diver on a budget. And of course, the review of this watch is on the channel. In the description of this video, there is a secret link. Check it out if you're curious. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you had fun, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
You got, what do you got here? What is it? What is it? What is it?